Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno says legislators are welcome to challenge the proposed merger of state-owned banks, Land Bank, and the Development Bank of the Philippines. Reacting to Senator Sherwin Gatchalian's resolution seeking an inquiry into the merger, Secretary Jokno says an investigation doesn't mean the merger will not push through. Land Bank President and CEO Lynette Ortiz, meanwhile, assuring the public they are ready to execute the merger. She adds merging the two banks, which will create the country's biggest lender, even bigger than BDO, will enable them to draw synergies while keeping true to their mandates as a development policy bank. Meanwhile, Finance Chief Ben Jokno also urging government agencies to catch up on their budget spending, calling out the Department of Information, Communications and Technology for being the slowest. Jokno also called out the Transport Department. Government spending in the first half of the year had a 0.42% reduction compared to the same period last year. Now, over 200 business leaders across 21 countries convened in Cebu over the weekend to propose new frameworks and models to the Asia-Pacific Economic Cooperation Meeting this November. Annie Pérez gives us a wrap of the developments from the third leg of this year's APEC Business Advisory Council meeting.
Business leaders all over the Asia-Pacific convened in Cebu for the past 3 days. They are the APEC Business Advisory Council, composed of 21 member economies. For this year, discussions focused on uplifting the micro, small, and medium entrepreneurs through digital innovation, economic sustainability, and environmental response.
We wanted to make sure that all the suggestions for economic growth and expansion would always take consideration of the needs of the people of this region, specifically helping the micro, small, and medium enterprises business, helping women business, helping indigenous business.
All five technical working groups created toolkits that are accessible to MSMEs. They also crafted frameworks to harmonize standards across the countries. However, they will be presented before a bigger audience this November, where state leaders are included in the discussion at San Francisco, USA. If approved, the frameworks will be implemented across APEC countries.
We have to work with our senior officials, so I think within APEC, we always have very good opportunities to present our case studies, our solutions. This would be an additional tool for an MSME to really get themselves up to that level that they want to achieve in terms of sustainability.
As for APEC Philippines, they decided on adopting economic resiliency practices. Leaders created an indemnity program with the National Treasury, where they can secure loans and bonds, including insurance policies in case another pandemic hits. Business leaders are set to lobby this proposal before the president and other stakeholders.
We learn from all countries, all 21 countries. So that's a big thing for us. And we're now able to give better advice to our government officials.
Philippine business leaders add this will tremendously help them stabilize their own financial assets and reduce the impact of losses that will also affect their workforce. Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.
In other news, several villages in Bacoor, Cavite will now be merged after the yes votes prevailed in a plebiscite held on Saturday. According to the Philippine poll body, 90% or around 29,000 of those who participated in the vote were in favor of the mergers. The plebiscite was held pursuant to a city ordinance signed by Bacoor's mayor, which aimed to merge villages to create economies of scale and boost economic growth. With its ratification, Bacoor's 44 villages will be trimmed down to 18, while 5 others will be renamed. Going now to macro news, economists projecting Philippine inflation in July eased for a 6th straight month, with some even seeing headline inflation falling below 5% from June's actual 5.4%. ING Bank citing favorable base effects while expecting core inflation, which excludes volatile food and energy prices, also easing to 7% from 7.4%. Meanwhile, Goldman Sachs looking there at 5.1%. That's their forecast, citing mainly higher vegetable and fish prices that are partially offset by lower electricity prices. As for Security Bank, It expects more volatility, especially in food, with weather-related disruptions, supply chain issues, and changes in consumer demand posing significant upside risks. The Philippine Central Bank has been on pause after pulling the trigger on 425 basis points of rate hikes to 5.25%, the most aggressive in the region, to fight inflation. The official reading for July inflation is going to be released on August 4. That's Friday. ANC will carry that live. And the BSP's next policy meeting is on August 17. A heads up for motorists. A big-time oil price hike looms for Tuesday. That's tomorrow. Estimates show diesel prices may go up for a fourth straight week by as much as 3 pesos and 50 centavos per liter. Gasoline may also see a jump of up to 2 pesos and 10 centavos. As for kerosene, it may see an increase of at least 2 pesos and 90 centavos per liter.